Sega.
Listen up. The rendezvous point is the shingle at the top of the beach. Use those defilades and keep moving. Do not stop until you reach the shingle. Clear the boat! Go! Go! Go!
Cable companies scattered all across the beach. We need to get to that shingle.
Shingle.
Get them to the shingle! Fall in, man! Get those engineers out of there! That cover's shut to hell! Engineer, move it! Now!
Engineer!
Listen up!
We got them
over!
spot! On deck!
Silence those 88s. Sergeant, round up your men.
All right, listen up. First squad, prepare to move out.
Take some pressure off our beachhead.
Listen
up. Those 88s are the objective.
Engineer! Satchel charges on the 88! Rifle squad! Come in the engineer! Come on! Okay! Go! Hustle up!
88 to deal with.
Go! Go!
Let's get a move on.
Ooh,
I'd rather see the inside of an engine.
Got a crow bunker over here! He's begging to get busted! Let's go! Let's go!
Let's go!
Engineers getting the piss pounded out of us!
Good work. Now get to those 88s, you bastards.
We got company! Enemy troops right fucking there! Move! We have the point!
Damn, oh God, get it!
Battery destroyed.
Excellent job, men. Sergeant Conti, get on the radio. Tell HQ our draw is clear for the tanks to come ashore.
Secure the perimeter and dig in. Inform Dog Company that we are in position and waiting for them to come ashore.
700 men died that morning on that tiny strip of sand. Another 1,500 wounded, 300 missing, dragged under the waves. Pearson, Williams, Krasinski. All good men. By sunset, over 156,000 men had come ashore. The invasion had begun. Or, as my CO used to say, hell opened its gates. The night before, the largest airborne operation in history dropped three divisions of paratroopers behind enemy lines. And their objective was to seize major roadways and prevent a counterattack that could jeopardize the entire invasion. Success on D-Day depended entirely on these men.